Martin Luther King Jr. Day is coming. It's time for you to get to know some interesting information about this social activist through our upcoming questions. Here's the first question. When and where was Martin Luther King born? A. February 15, 1929 in Boston, Massachusetts. B. January 15, 1929 in Atlanta, Georgia. C. April 4, 1968 in Memphis, Tennessee. The answer is B. January 15, 1929 in Atlanta, Georgia. You may not have heard this before, but Martin Luther King Jr. was not his birth name. His given name at birth was Michael King Jr., but his father later changed both of their names to Martin Luther in honor of the German Protestant leader. Question number two. What's the name of the college where he attended in Atlanta, Georgia? A. Morehouse College. B. Spelman College. C. Atlanta Technical College. The answer is A. Morehouse College. Do you know that Martin Luther King Jr. was admitted to Morehouse College at the age of 15? He skipped to grades in school and was the third generation of his family to go to this college. Such a gifted student. Question number three. What was his occupation? A. Doctor. B. Baptist minister. C. Social rights activist. The answer is B and C, Baptist minister and social rights activist. This may be new to you, but three of the greatest 20th century social activists are Dr. King, Mahatma Gandhi, and Nelson Mandela. Mahatma Gandhi was an Indian independence activist and leader who is best known for his philosophy of nonviolence and his role in leading India to independence from British rule. Nelson Mandela was a South African anti-apartheid revolutionary and statesman who is best known for his role in ending segregation and racial discrimination in South Africa. He served as president of South Africa from 1994 to 1999. Let's move on to the question number four. Where did the famous boycott against riding buses take place? A. Birmingham. B. Montgomery. C. Huntsville. The answer is B. Montgomery. In case you don't know, the boycott was successful because the U.S. Supreme Court, which is a group of very important judges, said segregation on buses was not fair and was against the law. This was a big win for the civil rights movement and helped make sure that everyone was treated equally, no matter what their skin color was. Question number five. From his cell in Birmingham, what did he compose? A. Stride Toward Freedom. B. Where Do We Go From Here? Chaos or Community? C. Letter from Birmingham Jail. The answer is C. Letter from Birmingham Jail. According to the King Center, he was imprisoned 29 times. Letter from Birmingham Jail was written on scraps of paper and in the margins of a newspaper because Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. didn't have any writing paper while he was in jail. Question number 6. What was the event called that took place in Washington on August 28, 1963? A. The March on Washington for Jobs and Freedom. B. Women's Suffrage Parade. C. The March for Our Lives. The answer is A. The March on Washington for Jobs and Freedom. You might be oblivious to this fact, but over 200 people came to the march to ask the government to make sure everyone was treated equally, no matter their skin color. Question number 7. What was he won on October 14, 1964? A. Nobel Literature Prize. B. Nobel Peace Prize. The answer is B. Nobel Peace Prize. These are some cool Nobel Prize facts you may find interesting. The first Nobel Prize was awarded in 1901. The Nobel Peace Prize is awarded in Oslo, Norway, while the other Nobel Prizes are awarded in Stockholm, Sweden. The Nobel Prizes are awarded on December 10th each year, which is the anniversary. Question number 8. When was Dr. King's last speech? A. February 4th, 1968. B. March 28th, 1968. C. April 3rd, 1968. The answer is C. April 3rd, 1968. How many speeches Dr. King gave in his lifetime? It's over 2,500 speeches. It's the question number 9 now. Why did Dr. King die? A. Suicide. B. Shot. C. Poison. The answer is B. Shot. Do you know that Dr. King was only 39 years old when he was assassinated in 1968? Despite his young age, he had accomplished a great deal in his lifetime and had become one of the most influential and respected leaders of the civil rights movement. Question number 10. What is his most famous speech? A. I've been to the mountaintop. B. Beyond Vietnam, a time to break silence. C. I have a dream. The answer is C. I have a dream. I Have a Dream was given at the March on Washington in 1963 and is considered one of the greatest speeches in American history. There is also a song with the same name as the speech given by Common and Will.i.am, and it honors Dr. Martin Luther King. And that's the last question in this video about Martin Luther King. We hope that you've enjoyed the video and have your knowledge broadened. If you're like this video, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel. Thanks for your support. See you next time.